All right, discussing the whims of war. Mao, in our particular eloquent society with electronics out there and our digital databases, if we do not embrace, I know this is a full turn on me for sure, if we do not embrace full identity per person, full identity compliance, we will end up war to war to war at the whim of a rich merchant, at the whim of a select group of rich people who have decided, hey, this country has come out of my fashion, they can all go impoverished now, so let those war over there, and they will starve, they will grovel, they will invade, they will even civil war upon our time, but we will not care, because we have made the hoarding money right there from the markets. So, we are merely entertaining. By not having identification each on a per person true, we are actually going into their pocket. Nothing changes. We are still underneath their slavedom. Now, when we drop it out like this, we cross the board with the wages and everybody getting money up front. Everybody ID'd up front. It puts it on a different level, doesn't it? It puts it on a different playing field. Because those ones before that were playing us down country for country, it's not a fashion that they can indulge in any longer. Because they will only own the particular properties that they have ever purchased. That's it. They can run back and forth and play that property game, but they will only be given the income from those properties up to a certain point, because each person will have the same exact amount of money, pretty close in income, on their wages to supply those exorbitant rich, hyperinflated, I'll call them, the dudes living in a fat cloud. All right, so what did we do? By becoming ID checked, well, how's it going to be done? There's all of those principles that we have to run down through. Because at this point in time, we are a scatter. We are a scare scatter from whoever owns the weapons. And this has to stop. The only way to delete that particular weaponry ownership is you take those dudes, you take those people who have the hyper monies out specifically for that, and you put them on an even wage with you. It changes everything, because then they only own their personal properties. Of course, you can say, they can run up and say, well, I own all of my whatever you call those things, tanks. Yeah, I suppose then they could say they own their tanks. Well, I don't want to buy a tank. Do you want to buy a tank? So their new person who is going to purchase that tank only has $44,000 in wages. Well, I suppose they could house swap. They could share. They could say, that's it, I'll take that property, and then a tank. So we're back to that. I guess they could go tank swapping for a house. Gosh dang it, I wish I had a pause on this button here. Anyway, yeah, they could tank swap for a house. What a bunch of jerks. Just, you know, my whole life, pretty much everybody's life, it wake up to this particular ordinance, this particular society of tank swapping over a house. That's pretty much what it all boils down to, is some jerks owning tanks. We got to get this out of our system. Do you understand?